Now, Thor Ragnarok is Chris Hemsworth's fifth outing as the hammer-throwing Thor, but for his Avengers co-star Mark Ruffalo, this is his first time in a Thor-based film. The two stars are in the country to promote the latest in the Marvel Studio franchise, and Angela Bishop caught up with them and director Taika Waititi.
So much has happened since I last saw you. I lost my hammer, like, yesterday, so that's still pretty fresh.
And then I went on a journey of self-discovery. Where I met you.
Did it seem at any stage that you were working for a living while you put this together?
No. I haven't had a job since 1994, I think.
Yes.
And I don't consider this a job at all.
Right.
And that's why I think we had so much fun. Because I kept reminding myself that, you know, we're so lucky to be in this industry, let alone having a job. Having a job is a reason to celebrate.
If this is a job, then I want to work.
The goddess of death has invaded Asgard.
Destiny has dire plans for you, my friend.
Well, I have dire plans for Destiny. I'm going to stop her.
Alone?
Nope.
I'm guessing there was a little bit of ad-libbing that went on this. Would that be fair to say?
There was.
In fact, you play a fantastic character.
Thank you.
Was any of that scripted? Or is that just you, Taika?
No, wasn't.
Yes, it was you.
Cool. Did you just get up there and just talk?
That's acting, isn't it? You know, I just talk with these guys. They just stand there and words come out of their faces, and you know, I'll just do that.
You thought, how hard can that be?
Turns out, super easy.
Sounds like you have a pretty special and intimate relationship with this hammer, and that losing it was almost comparable to losing a loved one.
It's a nice way of putting it.
I believe those. Quite a story about one particular line, and it's said in the trailer.
We know each other. He's a friend from work.
Young boy Darcy came to visit us on set one day, and he was a little unwell, and he basically, in between the scenes, I was going up and talked to him, and you know, and he just made the suggestion. He said, "You should say we know each other. He's a friend from work."
Yes, we know each other. He's a friend from work.
It's the best line in the movie.
He was from the Make-A-Wish Foundation.
Yeah.
What a beautiful story. Yeah. Isn't that fantastic? And you had final cut. Why did it stay in?
Well, you know, as a sort of a collector of good ideas, as the director of a major motion picture, it's my job and my sole job to basically snatch ideas
from other people
and then
put his name on them and then
take credit for them. So, well, I do give Darcy a lot of credit for inventing the greatest line in the movie.
It
was my decision to put it in, which actually made it my idea. So Darcy and I came up with that really cool line, really, in a way, you know? So, and I happily share that with that little genius.
And there, in a nutshell, is how Hollywood works.
Exactly.
We need to stop her here and now.
To prevent Ragnarok,
the end of everything.
So I'm putting together a team.
Like the old days.
Now, you got in a little bit of trouble, Mark, didn't you? A bit of a live streaming incident.
Am I
allowed to mention the war? Am I allowed to bring this up?
If you want.
You accidentally live streamed a bit of the movie?
Yeah, I did do that.
Was it an accident?
I mean, it turned out quite good, didn't it?
It did. It turned out pretty good.
I mean, we're putting our phones in little pouches.
Yeah,
we're all been
that
good.
After I did that.
Oh, it's your fault.
I think so. I'm sorry about that.
Whoa. So what were you thinking?
Well, look who decided.
I don't know what happened to me that night. I thought I'd shut it off. They asked me to Instagram Live the backstage stuff that night.
Right.
Marvel asked me to do that. I never did Instagram Live. I don't know how this works. So I did it and I shot it and they're like, okay, get to your seat, hurry. And I pushed the button. That's like you push a button, it's supposed to stop, but you have to push two buttons. So I pushed one button and I put it in my pocket and I'm sitting there 6 minutes into the movie and a woman that I don't even know comes up and she pokes me. And she's like, turn your phone off. Your Instagram Live is still on. It's broadcasting the whole movie. And I'm like,
you're in my seat.
I would love for someone else to rule, but it can't be you. You're just the worst.
I knew that Joaquin Phoenix was going to be on a plane. these guys don't have a problem firing you. They don't like you. They just fire you. This has been two other Hulks already now, dude. I mean, they have no qualms just canning your ass. And there's a line of people there waiting to play this part.
We're the same, you and I. Just a couple of hot-headed fools.
Yeah, same. Hulk like fire, Thor like water.
Oh. Kind of both like fire.
But Hulk like raging fire. Thor like smoldering fire.
Johnny, you were at the premiere of Meet the Other Night. We're not allowed to review the film. We have an embargo until Friday. It'll be on date night next week. But they're very funny, aren't they?
Very, very
funny. That did not look like work, Angela.
Did not look like work. No. They had a very big night the night before. I'm just going to put that out there. They had about a 4:30 finish because all their family in town and everything. Yeah, so.
No, it looks like they were having a very
good
time.
Amazing people to hang out with.
And Johnny used to work with Chris.
He was on Home and Away, for a little while. And then he went over to LA, so.
Wow.
And what did he get then? You know,
Didn't work out much for him.
What was it like for him being the second most handsome person on a show for once?
I don't know. You'll have to ask him. You tell me.
That's right.
Thor Ragnarok opens across the nation next week.
Awesome, Ange.